we're in this new sort of paradigm of there is not enough available energy to meet the energy demands of AI, manufacturing.
Changing the World Technology with George Levy. Brought to you by Blockchain Institute of Technology and AI Institute of Technology.
Hi, and welcome to Changing the World Technology, where we feature the leading minds and personalities in blockchain, AI, and the technologies that are changing the world. Today's guest is Sue Ennis. Sue is a recognized leader in emerging technology and innovation with 15 years of experience driving growth in North America's tech, energy, and small cap sectors. As head of investor relations at Hut 8, she leverages her expertise to boost visibility and investment. Over her career, Sue has raised over $1 billion for structured products and small cap companies, turning fintech and digital asset firms into multi-billion dollar entities. Her previous roles include VP of Global Partnerships at Shift Networks and leadership positions at Coinsquare, Voyager, and Invesco. Sue also serves on the boards of DeFi Technologies, Inc. and Realbotics and advises Losera Vision. Sue, I am so very excited to be doing this interview. Looking forward to speaking with you.
Yeah, thrilled to be here today. So much is happening in the energy and the small cap space, particularly in Canada. So let's definitely get into it.
Yeah, I've been following Hut 8 for a very long time. I actually live in Miami. I've actually seen your headquarters in Miami, which are absolutely gorgeous. And there's a lot of stuff going down here in Miami. So Hut 8 is one of these companies that I hold near and dear because you're right in my backyard. So great to see you. Very excited.
Yeah, awesome. So we actually were originally a Canadian-based crypto miner. We started in late 2017, went public in 2018, and we executed one of the largest mergers in the crypto industry in December of 2023 and re-domiciled to the US. So originally our headquarters was not in Miami. We were Canadian, but since we re-domiciled to the US, yeah, love being here in Miami. We also were recently added to the Russell 3000 index, which we were only able to be added to because we are now an American company, and a lot of obviously funds and pension plans build their mandates off that. So it was a really big deal for us to now headquarter in Miami, and lots of benefits for our shareholders.
Yeah, one thing that I love about, and by the way, I've been following Hut 8. I know Asher Janoot is actually the CEO. He was recently appointed this year, and he's been very, very open about all that happened with the halving. I've been following the Bitcoin mining space for a lot of time. But one of the things that I love about Hut 8 is that Hut 8 does a lot of Bitcoin mining, but there's also other elements to the company. You're in the AI space, high performance computing. There's so much going on right now. So I'd like you to talk to me a little bit about that, because sometimes when people think about a Bitcoin mining firm, you know, you think about the vulnerabilities of, we got the Bitcoin mining, we got the halving, then there's control supply, so much competition for hash rate. But the bigger picture, Hut 8 plays in so many different areas.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think the way to think about Hut 8 is we have three layers to our business. So first, we've got the power layer, and that's where we manage a scaled portfolio of pure play power assets. Then we've got the infrastructure layer. So you can sort of look at the power piece of our business as almost like the operating system. Then we've got the infrastructure layer, and that is where we build purpose-built data centers on top of that power layer. So whether it be AI training data centers, Bitcoin mining data centers, or maybe one day green hydrogen data centers. That's the sort of the second layer of our business. So you can kind of look at it as the app store. And then we've got the third layer of our business, and that's the compute layer. So that's where we maximize the return on that infrastructure with compute. Again, whether it be GPU as a service in the AI space or mining Bitcoin, or whatever, our whole thesis effectively is that as technology continues to evolve, the use case for the electron, the availability of compute will also continue to evolve. And Bitcoin mining is our tool to capture the current and future value of stranded electrons and then continue to build our business across those three layers. And so that final layer, that compute layer, you can look at it almost as the actual app itself that's built on in the app store. That app store being our infrastructure layer. So that's sort of the lay of the land with Hut 8. I think at the end of the day, we really look at ourselves more so as a power and development company versus just being a Bitcoin miner or an AI data center or an AI operator, data center operator, or GPU as a service operator. At the end of the day, all of this compute, all of this infrastructure is driven by power. And right now we are in an environment where there is a tremendous scarcity of power, and new power is going to continue to need to be unlocked in order for humanity as a whole to continue to develop in the AI space, EV space, repatriation of manufacturing. And this is where, again, there's a really interesting overlap between power and Bitcoin. But again, that's sort of the lay of the land, is we use Bitcoin as our tool to capture the current and future value of stranded electrons.
Yeah, I love that vision, because one of the key things that I want, and actually this is going to bring up a different topic. If you're a power firm and you're actually looking about how to deliver power, and like Bitcoin mining is only one part of it, what about sustainability? Because a lot of times when people talk about power, we're like, you know what, there's all these different sources of it. How do you approach the topic of sustainability?
Yeah, so I think, you know, there's certain, and I will say the narrative and the rhetoric is changing, but up until probably about a year ago, there was still quite a bit of FUD in the media and misinformation percolating, even at the highest levels of government, in terms of how pollutive Bitcoin mining is. And on the mining side, we really look at ourselves as partners in the transition to renewable energy. And what do I mean by that? So one of the problems with renewable power, i.e. solar, wind, et cetera, is that it's incredibly intermittent. And you need a load balancing tool to co-locate with that intermittent power. So now oftentimes wind and solar power are co-located with nuclear power plants or nat gas power plants. But in this case, Bitcoin mining is actually an incredible load balancing tool, because we can power up and power down given wherever the grid is at from a constraint perspective. So for example, if there is too much demand on the grid and the grid is getting strained, we can easily power down our operations in order to smooth out some of that volatility. If there's not enough demand on the grid, we can easily power up our operations and make sure that that grid stays balanced at all times. So that's another thing that grids need, is they need to be balanced at all times. So this is, as we look at the tremendous amount of renewable power coming online, I think there's something like 26 gigawatts of solar and wind coming online in the next couple of years. We see Bitcoin mining as a real tool and a partner in that transition to renewable power. Another thing I will say is, again, there was quite a bit of FUD. There still is some FUD in the media about Bitcoin miners only using fossil fuels in order to power their operations. So something like 38%+ of grids worldwide are still reliant on fossil fuels and heavy pollutive emissions and heavily pollutive sources. And so a lot of Bitcoin miners are connected to grids. And so again, this isn't so much an issue of Bitcoin miners just guzzling gas and coal, et cetera. A lot of us are plugged into the grids, and it's a grid problem. There is still a tremendous amount of pollutants that are powering all of our grids. And quite frankly, we don't necessarily think that's going away, because as I mentioned earlier, we're in this new sort of paradigm of there is not enough available energy to meet the energy demands of AI, manufacturing, electric vehicles, et cetera. And so we do think we're going to start to see more nat gas coming online. We're already starting to see more nuclear power coming online. And obviously nuclear power is much less carbon intensive than other sources of energy. But again, it's not so much in our opinion that Bitcoin miners are the problem. We really are a partner in the solution.
Excellent. And I love that vision, because one thing that I'm looking at, and I'm from what I'm gathering from you, so the space is evolving. And what I'm saying is, like, today is Bitcoin mining. I know that the vision is going into AI, high power computing. Everybody's talking about all the GPU, all these different technologies. And yet everything has to evolve. So what you're saying, from what I gather, is that Hut 8 serves as a partner to make that evolution move forward more efficiently. That's another key thing. I know that Hut 8 is very, very focused on efficiency. Can you talk a little bit about efficiency? Because I know that's important. How much it costs you to mine one Bitcoin, how much it costs to run the business. And I know you have a big, big focus on efficiency.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, when the number one input to your business is power, and then obviously machines, you want to make sure efficiency is paramount, particularly when efficiency is very important in terms of maintaining margins, particularly if you're going after a volatile asset like Bitcoin, because obviously the price can be quite volatile. So you want to make sure that you have a way to maintain lean and mean operations and continue to clip healthy margins to keep a sustainable business in all the other areas of your business. Because we do look at some areas of our business as being able to fund other operating areas of our business. Another sort of piece in the story of Hut 8 is we had a CEO transition in February, And prior to Asher taking over, we never disclosed our cost of power. It was quite high. But Asher did quite a few moves in terms of being able to, across our portfolio, get our power down from being almost undisclosable to now 3.2 cents per kilowatt hour.
Wow.
3.2 cents per kilowatt hour is a very competitive power price across our portfolio. We've been able to obtain that price point for a variety of different things. So number one, shutting down inefficient sites, bringing on cheaper power sites, but also we have proprietary curtailment in-house software and hardware and curtailment that enables us to strategically curtail and get very opportunistic when power prices are volatile. So because we're so good at that, we've got a very sophisticated energy team who particularly has a very high acumen in terms of curtailing, despite the price of Bitcoin. So despite the halving event, so getting 50% more difficult or rewards being cut in half in April of this year, our cost per coin only went up by 7% versus some of our peers. You saw their cost per coin go up exponentially. And effectively, we were able to run our machines that are currently 31.7 joules per terahash, closer to like a 28 to 29 joule per terahash on the efficiency side. And we also just announced that we are ready to do a major machine and fleet upgrade. And we effectively skipped a generation of efficiency, which was also a strategic move for us. So yeah, so these are all things in our opinion that are going to catalyze even more leaner and meaner operations for Hut 8.
That's excellent. You know, one of the key things, you bring up some really, really visionary approaches, and I'm really excited about what's coming next. Can you give me sort of a vision of, like, there's a lot of innovation going on. I know H2 2024, there's a lot of talk about the AI elements within Hut 8. You're actually moving towards, I mean, it's kind of a bold statement, but to go to revenue generating, there's a lot of things going in there. Can you talk a little bit about that, about the vision moving forward?
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm going to go back to what I said at the beginning of this podcast. I think that the way that we at the end of the day look at ourselves as power and infrastructure operators, and one day there's a world where perhaps Hut is managing in the low teens of gigawatts of power under management, but we use Bitcoin mining as a tool to keep capturing cheap megawatts that no one wants and then flip those assets to the next highest return on Electron as that technology use case evolves and presents itself. And in this case, for some sites that have water, that have fiber, it's now looking like AI training data centers are perhaps the next best use case for that Electron on some of the Bitcoin mining sites in our portfolio and in our competitor portfolio. But as you know, as we look at other things, like for example, green hydrogen, water desalination, those are all areas where we could potentially see, again, a higher return on Electron. And so that's why our whole thesis is we are power and infrastructure operators first, and Bitcoin mining is our tool to keep building that portfolio of cheap megawatts into the future.
That's excellent. Thank you so very much for sharing that. Sue, I really appreciate the opportunity to speak with you, learn more about Hut 8. Thank you very much for coming to the show.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me, George. Happy to chat with you anytime.
Changing the World Technology with George Levy. Brought to you by Blockchain Institute of Technology and AI Institute of Technology.